A safety case and safety case report shows how and why your buildings are designed and constructed to be safe and of a good standard, and how they'll stay safe for people living in them. It won't replace existing legal requirements, and you must still comply with them. The safety case is all the information you use to manage the risk of fire spread and your building's structural safety. You may already have some of the information that you need, but under the proposed new safety case regime, you'll need to use this information in a new way. Your safety case will need to demonstrate the current and ongoing safety of your building. You'll have to think about how all the things you do work together to stop or reduce the impact of a fire spread or structural failure. Your safety case should identify potentially harmful events and show that you have the necessary measures in place to prevent, control, and mitigate risks. The safety case report summarizes your safety case and must be tailored to your particular building. The safety case report should show the major fire and structural hazards within your building and show how you're managing the risks they present. Your safety case report should provide the reader with confidence that the associated risks are being reduced and that proportionate steps are being taken to make sure they'll be kept under control and managed in the future. How to start your report? Draw together a clear description of your building. Think about the major accidents involving fire spread and structural safety that could affect your building. Describe the steps you've taken to prevent major fire and structural accidents and minimize their impact, and how measures such as emergency evacuation and firefighting arrangements will affect people. Show how you make sure the measures will work when needed. Think about whether your measures and your safety management system will protect the residents from major accident hazards and whether other actions are needed. Put together a process to ensure any modifications to the building include fire and structural safety considerations.